Welcome to the IT Free Training video on Starter GPOs and copying group policy objects. If you create a lot of group policies that are similar, this video will show you how to speed up that process. This video also looks at how to copy group policy objects in the same domain and between different domains. You have probably come across a template before. For example, in an office, it is not uncommon for the office to have a fax template. Each time you want to send a fax, you simply copy the fax template and make any changes that you require. Group policy has a template feature called Starter GPOs. Since there is already a section in group policy called Administrative Templates, it is most likely that Microsoft did not want to use the term template again. For this reason, the name Starter GPOs was used, but essentially they work the same way as a traditional template would work. Although a starter GPO is copied to a new group policy, just like you would expect a template to be, it does not include all the settings in group policy. The starter GPO only includes the administrative template part of group policy. If you require all the settings, there is also a copy option that I will look at, which will allow you to copy a complete group policy object. I will now change to my Windows Server to have a look at how to configure Starter GPOs and copy Group Policy objects. First of all, I will open Group Policy Management from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. The first feature of Group Policy that I will look at is Starter GPOs, found under Starter GPOs. Starter GPOs are not configured by default. To start using Starter GPOs, select the option Create Starter GPOs folder. You will notice that once this option is selected, a number of Starter GPOs are created. These were added with Windows Server 2008 R2. If you are not running Windows Server 2008 R2, you can add these Starter GPOs by downloading the latest version of the remote server administration tools. The first Starter GPO is Windows Vista EC Computer. EC stands for Enterprise Client. Windows Vista EC Computer is a number of computer group policy settings that Microsoft recommends for the standard enterprise client. Below this, you can see Windows Vista SSLF Computer. SSLF stands for Specialized Security Limited Functionality. SSLF is used for highly secure environments and environments with a high risk of attack. It is designed to protect information with the highest value. For example, government systems holding confidential information. Any SSLF starter GPOs tighten up security on the system, making it more secure and resistant to attack. This starter GPO is for the computer side of group policy, but there are starter GPOs for the user side as well. If you wanted to create a new Starter GPO, you can right-click on Starter GPO and select New. To create the Starter GPO, all you need to do is enter in a name and a comment if you wish. Once the Starter GPO is created, I can then right-click on it and select Edit. Notice that the Starter GPOs only have administrative templates. You cannot configure any other setting in a Starter GPO. For this demonstration, I will configure the desktop wallpaper under User Configuration. You are free to configure as many settings as you want. Once complete, the next step is to go back into Group Policy Management and create a new Group Policy object. In this case, I will create a new Group Policy under London by selecting the option Create a GPO in this domain and link it here. In this case, I will enter in the name as London Office. Under this, notice that I have the option to select Source Starter GPO. In this case, I will select the Starter GPO that I just created called Default Branch Office. The group policy has been created and linked under the London OU using the Starter GPO as the template. If I edit the group policy object, notice how I have the option to edit any setting in the group policy that I want. In the Starter GPO, I only had the option to edit administrative templates. If I expand down in the user settings and down to the desktop settings, notice that the setting desktop wallpaper that I configured in the Starter GPO is configured. If I edit the settings, notice that I have complete control over it. I can even select the option Not Configured. Once the Starter GPO is used to create a group policy object, you have complete control over which settings you change or leave. Also, any changes that you make do not affect the original Starter GPO. If you know what default settings you want to use in advance, Starter GPOs can be very useful. In some cases, you may already have the group policy created that you want to copy and later modify. This group policy may be in the same domain or in a different domain. If the group policy is in the same domain, it is a simple matter to copy the group policy object. In this case, I will open Active Directory Users and Computers and create a new organizational unit called Washington. Once the OU is created, I can go back into Group Policy Management and press F5 to refresh the view. In this case, I want to copy an existing group policy and link to Washington. To do this, expand into the Group Policy Objects, right-click the group policy object that you want to copy, and select Copy. The next step is to right-click Group Policy Objects and select Paste. You will get the option to keep the existing permissions or use the default permissions. If you are not sure, select the option for default permissions for new GPOs. It does not take long to copy the group policy. Once complete, I will rename the group policy object. Once the group policy object is copied and a suitable name given, the next step is to link the group policy to the required OU. In some cases, you may want to copy a group policy object from a different domain. If you want to copy the group policy object from domain to domain, one trick you can do is right-click the group policy object that you want to copy and select the option Backup. In this case, I will choose to back up the group policy to the desktop. Once I enter in the optional description, I will press Backup to back up the group policy to the desktop. Once the backup is complete, the next step is to import the settings. Since the settings will be imported, it is a good idea to create a new group policy. If you use an existing group policy object, you will merge the backed up setting with the settings that exist in the group policy. In this case, I will create a new group policy object, LA. Once this is created, I can right-click the group policy object and select the option Import Settings. Once in the Import Wizard, I will skip past the welcome screen. The next screen gives you the option to back up the GPO before starting the import. This is a good idea if you are merging the settings with an existing group policy. In this case, I am importing the settings into a brand new empty group policy, so I will not worry about backing up the settings. On the next screen, I need to give the path where I backed up the previous group policy. On the next screen, it should have a list of the group policy objects that are available to be imported. It is a good idea, before the import, to press the button View Settings. This will allow you to see the settings that will be imported. Before the settings are imported, the wizard will do a quick check for any UNC paths. UNC paths access a share directly by the server and share name. For this reason, if you import the settings from a different forest, it is possible that settings exist that reference a server that is not accessible from this domain. Once I press Finish on the wizard, the group policy settings will be imported. Using this method gives you a way of copying group policy between domains in different forests. Thanks for watching this video from ITFreeTraining. This video is part of the free Active Directory course. For more videos from this course and others, please feel free to visit our website or YouTube channel. You can also subscribe to our channel to ensure that you have the latest videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.